can't believe I'm really here! Psychonauts headquarters!
It has been 16 years and 4 months since the release of the original Psychonauts, and while that feels like absolute eons for those who love that game, and also those who then chose to back the sequel's development, which was almost 6 years ago, for Raz and the Psychonauts, it's actually just been a matter of days and hours. Psychonauts 2 picks up right where the VR interquel Psychonauts and the Rhombus of Ruin left off, with an audacious mind heist into the twisted psyche of Dr. Loboto. It's an opening that poses so many questions for the rest of the game to solve. Who was Dr. Loboto working for? What has he done with Zanotto? And who is the mysterious, huge, towering figure that is tormenting him? Don't worry though if you haven't played the original or its VR offshoot, because Psychonauts 2's story works well enough in its own right. The opening missions are great at resetting Raz's character arc as a plucky intern at the Psychonauts, while still retaining many of the powers that he learnt in the first game, so it's not a complete reset, and it then refocuses the narrative on this new story arc and a new set of characters. It doesn't take long before the returning cast of modern Psychonauts, your Sasha 9, Mia Vidello, and Coach Oleander, they start to take a back seat to the adventure, and Raz finds himself with 2 daunting missions to complete. Firstly, to root out a mole in the Psychonauts organization, and secondly, to reunite the Psychic 6, the founding members of the Psychonauts. It was they who first defeated the great evil that was Maligula, that towering figure that torments Dr. Loboto, and they will certainly be needed if the Psychonauts are going to be able to do so again. Getting them back out of retirement is not as easy as just giving them a quick phone call, though. In the years since that titanic battle with Maligula, each of the 6 has begun to struggle with the mental anguish and pain of that battle, and the consequences of the actions that they took and what followed. With their permission, Raz will have to delve into each of their minds to try and help them overcome the demons that hide within. For Compton Bool, it's an endless struggle with anxiety and the cacophony of voices that he feels always criticizing him, while Cassie O'Pear has to reconcile the different sides of her personality and the different fronts that she has had to present to the world in the past in order to survive. As you would expect after the first game, stepping into the minds of others leads to all manner of twisted and otherworldly settings. The world's both a representation of who they are and what it is that afflicts them. The visual design throughout, though, is excellent, taking that German expressionist style of the original game and making it look so much more tactile throughout much of the game world, but with some of the minds then dramatically shifting the art style or the scenario that Raz finds himself in. Turning again to Cassie's mind, hers is carved through the paper of books, the spaces that you run through often filled with living paper cutouts of hand drawings, who are all nice and amusing to talk to. And then there's psychedelia, there's game shows, and so much more to be found elsewhere. There's a tenderness to how Double Fine tells each and every character's story. As you will read in the game's mental health advisory at the start of the game, there are representations of addiction, PTSD, panic attacks, anxiety, and delusions. But while there's often a comedic tone to the surrounding elements, there's a great deal of empathy shown for each character's struggles. It's worth saying that none of the characters are completely fixed by Raz's interventions, but he is able to help break them out of the vicious cycles that torment them and help them start to heal on their own terms. Of course, with this being a Double Fine game and Tim Schafer penning the story, there is still plenty of comedy to be found throughout the game. There's tons of one-liners and little gags that had me chuckling along. But better yet, the story and the mystery surrounding Maligula and the mole within the Psychonauts have some great twists and turns that I didn't put together until the last moment. Psychonauts 2 makes all of the advances that you would expect after 2 full console generations. The platforming is tighter, and you have powers like levitation right from the off that make getting around just that much more enjoyable. There's also the new abilities, such as Mental Connection, which lets you zip between highlighted points for added variety to the platforming action. You'll want to keep an eye out for these off to one side as well, because if you're a completionist, there are sometimes hundreds of figments and other collectibles in this series' take on the collectathon. It might sometimes feel like Double Fine have gone a little bit too far with the collectathon aspect, but it never really gets too out of hand once you get to the end of each level and look back at the percentage and variety of the collectibles that you've managed to pick up. Mental Connection also comes in use in combat, letting you pull enemies towards you or you towards larger enemies for a quick melee strike. It's in the combat that you really feel how much the controls and the abilities have been improved. You can keep on the move, use Psy Blast at range, pyrokinesis to deal with groups of enemies, and you'll quickly learn to pick out the special enemies that need extra attention or specific tactics and abilities in order to take them out. It can get quite hectic, and it is a little bit button bashy at times, especially as the final act increases the frequency of combat that you face, but it's much more fun than I found it to be in the original. A decade and a half on from that original game, Psychonauts 2 is clearly a worthy sequel and successor to Double Fine's cult classic. The fundamental platforming and combat is much tighter, the world design is as varied and inventive as ever, and while the story is full of twists, turns, and comedy, there's a wonderful sense of empathy and tenderness for all of the characters here. Simply put, Psychonauts 2 has been well worth the wait. Thanks as ever for coming along and checking out our video. I hope you've enjoyed what you've seen. Before you go though, make sure to like, subscribe, hit the bell icon, and maybe even consider coming over to thesixthaxis.com to visit our written content. Hopefully, we will see you again soon. Goodbye!